Duchenne muscular dystrophy is a genetic disorder that causes progressive muscle degeneration and weakness. This condition is caused by dystrophin deficiency, a protein crucial for maintaining muscle cell structure. Without dystrophin, muscle cells are easily damaged, leading to inflammation. The inflammation, clinically manifested by progressive muscle weakness and degeneration, can lead to muscle fibrosis. Primarily affecting boys, symptoms often appear between the ages 2 and 3. As the disease progresses, it can severely impact lung and heart functions, ultimately leading to a fatal outcome. Corticosteroids have been a mainstay treatment for Duchenne muscular dystrophy for many years. Their primary use is to reduce inflammation and improve muscle function, which can help prevent deformities and maintain strength. However, these medications are associated with several significant side effects, including stunted growth, decreased bone density, and weight gain, limiting their long-term effectiveness. In October 2023, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved Vamorolone, marketed as Agamree, for treating people with Duchenne muscular dystrophy, ages 2 and older. But how does Vamorolone come into play? Vamorolone is a novel medication that is similar to traditional corticosteroids, but with a reduced risk of harmful side effects. It is structurally unique compared with corticosteroids commonly used to treat DMD. Consider Vamorolone as a more targeted and refined approach to treatment, balancing effectiveness and safety. Vamorolone is a liquid suspension intended to be taken by mouth. It works by binding to glucocorticoid receptors in the body. This action helps reduce inflammation in muscle tissue, slowing down progression of muscle damage. Vamorolone also helps stabilize muscle cell membranes, protecting muscle fibers from further breakdown. A key difference between Vamorolone and traditional glucocorticoids is its ability to selectively suppress nuclear factor kappa B, or NF-kappa B, and inflammation. Unlike traditional corticosteroids, vamorolone does not activate the glucocorticoid response element, or GRE. GREs mediate the transcriptional pathway that leads to many of the adverse effects, such as bone fragility and growth suppression, commonly associated with traditional steroids. The FDA approved vamorolone based on data from the pivotal Phase 2b Vision DMD study. The randomized double-blind study was conducted on 121 boys, aged 4 to 6, with confirmed Duchenne muscular dystrophy and were able to walk. None of the participants had received corticosteroid treatment before. Patients were randomized to receive vamorolone 2 mg or 6 mg per kilogram, prednisone 0.75 mg per kilogram, or placebo daily for 24 weeks. The primary measure of muscle strength and function was the time to stand velocity or speed. At week 24, boys who received vamorolone 6 mg per kilogram per day stood up significantly faster than those boys who received placebo. This improvement was clinically meaningful, exceeding the smallest number of change we consider significant in clinical practice, which is 0.02 rise per second. In addition, they also walked farther and faster. Prednisone-treated patients experienced a notable decline in height from baseline compared to vamorolone-treated participants. Additionally, markers of bone turnover, including osteocalcin, P1NP, and CTX1, decreased significantly with prednisone but remained relatively stable with vamorolone. These results suggest that vamorolone treatment appeared to be better tolerated than traditional corticosteroid therapy, with fewer adverse effects like growth retardation and detrimental bone outcomes. While vamorolone is a significant step forward, ongoing research continues to explore even more effective treatments. Gene therapy and stem cell-based therapy are promising candidates. Together, these advancements could revolutionize Duchenne muscular dystrophy management, improving the quality of life for patients. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.